Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy with Van Aan & Company. It's Thursday, August 24th. I'm going to go over the markets with you here for the day. So crop tour estimates still coming in a little bit on the friendly side. So you're coming in here to Iowa and having some disappointing yields throughout Iowa for both corn and then pod counts quite a bit lower. And then even working their way into Minnesota, seeing some lower pod counts, actually anywhere from 600 to 800 when you're used to about 1200. Once you got a decent amount into Minnesota, yields drastically picked up on corn, having some really monster yields out there for Minnesota. So well above 200 bushel per acre on a lot of these fields that they're taking from Minnesota. Pod counts fantastic. And that's what the market was expecting, that Iowa or that Minnesota would carry yield. We've had ideal growing season here so far. When you talk to farmers, they say that their crop looks just as good as last year on their record crop. And so you were expecting these. We should get a yield number for Iowa as a whole here this evening. And then tomorrow after the close, they'll go over national yield of how they want to peg it for both corn and then give an idea on soybeans here. So you did have corn steady to up a half a cent. I do think you probably would have seen corn up a little bit more if it weren't for so much old crop that has to get sold. There's a lot of corn on DP and the contracts should be running out here today, tomorrow, and into Monday, that a lot of corn is going to get sold, and that's where you're struggling just a little bit. But soybeans had phenomenal export sales here this morning and then also had another private sale to China. So you saw some demand pick up, and then also these friendly pod cotton numbers, you were able to get Nove beans up about 8.5 cents. Over in the wheat market, found some support as well, anywhere from 8 to 11 cents higher. Meat markets traded both sides. Most of the day you were quite a bit lower here into the cattle markets, able to come back just a little bit. And the outside markets really didn't do a whole lot except for crude. Crude oil was actually down about $1 to $1.50 majority of the day after reversing here and starting to find some support levels mid 47 per barrel. Most thinking that you could see it come down to that $45 mark here as you're finding a bit of pressure around it. Tomorrow, like I said, all eyes will be on where you're seeing some more yields come in and seeing if you get any hints at where we might have this yield for a national average come in, and then also see what managed money here did from last Tuesday to Tuesday, as they're still a little bit long on the corn side, though after this week you should be seeing them on the short side of things. I do have to close with the disclaimer: trading in futures and options involves risk of loss and may not be suitable for all producers. Have a great day.